The great British countryside. Our mountains, our lakes, our hillsides, and our valleys. This is the open space for everyone to enjoy, with our friends, our family, and our dogs. It's perfect, until something like this happens. As one of the very many livestock farmers in the UK that lives his life in the countryside and enjoys the open air, I want to welcome many other people to come and enjoy my office. But if they do come, please keep your dog under control, on a lead, because your dogs can be a serious problem to our sheep. The majority of dogs' natural instinct is to chase and to kill. I've seen what happens with my own eyes when sheep are attacked by dogs. It's not nice for us as farmers, it's not nice to get the police involved, and it's not nice for the dog owner, because everybody loses.
As the North Wales Police Rural Crime Team, we get called to a tremendous amount of livestock attacks. And it's not just sheep, it's all sorts of different animals. So you're looking at cows, you're looking at horses, all sorts, you know, chickens even. You know, when we first started in our roles, we were having just the occasional reports of sheep herding. And we did think, this is a bit strange, you know, why aren't we getting any more? Because it seems to be happening often, anecdotally. As soon as we started digging into the surface and spoke to farmers and started prosecuting people for these offences, we realised that, in fact, you know, that there were loads of these attacks happening.
Sergeant Rob Taylor, head of North Wales Rural Crime Team, explains the law.
Section 1 of the Livestock Act of 1953 is very clear, and it states that people can't have their dog in the vicinity of livestock without being on a lead. Now, the consequences of this are dire, because the farmer can quite legally shoot the dog at the time, an owner can be taken to court, and that it really means facing a large fine, also compensation to the farmer, and the reality that the dog could be put down. I mean, in North Wales alone, over the past 2 years, we've seen in excess of 300 separate attacks and the deaths of over 1,000 sheep. And this is something that's reflected throughout the UK. There's no winners in this. The farmer loses his sheep, the sheep is brutalised, the dogs are often either shot at the scene or taken to court and destroyed under an order. And of course, you have the owners losing their pet as well. I mean, owning a dog brings responsibility, and part of that responsibility is using a lead when you're in the presence of livestock. I mean, we as police officers see the consequences on a daily and weekly basis of this. We have farmers that often ring us in tears. We have dog owners who have the dog shot at the scene, or we have dog owners that end up in court and have to face a large fine and also having their dog put down. My team also have to turn up on a daily basis and see the devastation that's caused by an attack. Now, this isn't just a sheep that's chased around a field. This is a sheep that's had harrowing injuries caused to it over a lengthy amount of time. So there is no winners with this. There is no winners at all. And like I said before, responsibility comes with owning a dog.
We've had quite a few over the past few years, more so that we've started to report them, especially with social media and everything. It's a good way of getting the message out about sheep worrying. We had one experience, it's quite a nasty one really. A woman came down to the house, knocked on the door and explained to us what she'd just seen, which is a gentleman kicking his dog to get it off a sheep. And he got the dog away from the sheep and they just carried on walking. It was walkers. The woman came down, she was really upset about what she'd seen. I went back up to get the sheep and the sheep's head had literally been crushed and there was blood pouring out of its eyes and its mouth. It was horrible.
Countryside vet Helen Cowie explains it's a growing problem.
I've been practicing for, you know, a number of years now, and it's certainly something we see, you know, on a regular basis, all too frequently, really. And that can be dealing with, you know, from the farmer's side of things, so dealing with the livestock, treating injuries, infections from injuries, or other diseases as a consequence of sort of stress, but also treating the dogs, or potentially often, sadly, having to put them down because they have been involved in this or have attacked, you know, some livestock. So, yeah. There is quite a big misconception about, you know, the fact that perhaps it's only large breed dogs, you know, the bigger dogs that could cause injuries to sheep. But actually, at the end of the day, you know, dogs are dogs. So whether it's your small chihuahuas or your labradoodles or your larger breed dogs, any dog has the potential to cause either physical injuries or stress and worry and disease in livestock. And it may not be the fact that the animal is aggressive, but they may be playing, trying to chase the sheep and doing it in a non-aggressive way. But obviously sheep are a prey species at the end of the day, and obviously they won't see it from that perspective, and that's when then you get the sort of diseases and problems sort of occur.
I'm a dog lover. I spend more time with my dogs than I do with my wife and family. But I've had to shoot somebody else's dog because it was attacking and killing our sheep. And that, to me, was really difficult. It was a spaniel. I knew who the dog owner was, but I just couldn't catch him. And the only thing I could do was to shoot him. And it broke my heart. Over in the foothills of Snowdonia, Nesta tells her family's experience.
On the 8th of May 2015, our dog Oreo killed a sheep and he had to be put down, which meant that it was our responsibility as the owner to make all the preparations to have him put down and take him to the vet ourselves and bring him home and have a burial for him. On the day that Oreo was being put down, we picked him up from the kennels. We took him to the beach. We bought him loads of treats. It was a lovely day. He really enjoyed it. We took him to the vets by 5 o'clock and we had to make all the arrangements. And it was really heartbreaking, really, because the boys were crying and we had to watch our dog being put to sleep and then wrapped him in a bag, put him in the boot of the car and brought him home, and we had to and then bury him the following day. It was heartbreaking, to be honest. It was one of the worst days of my life. Oreo was almost like the fifth child I never had, and we loved him to bits. He was such a character. And putting him down and watching him being put down was the worst thing that I've ever witnessed. It was horrible. Yeah, the whole family was affected, not just the immediate family, the whole family, and friends as well, because Oreo was such a character. He was loved by everybody. I think if I hadn't have fallen in love so much with this dog, I don't think I would have been so much heartbroken. But if you are a dog lover, you know, keep them safe.
Having to put animals down, you know, is never an easy thing to do. Never mind when they're actually, you know, it's an older dog or they're poorly. But having to put a healthy dog down is particularly, you know, not a very nice thing to have to do. Not only from the dog's point of view, but also the owners. You know, often the owners are very distraught, understandably, and they're, you know, dealing with their emotions as well, and you know, we're having to console them, you know, understandably and rightly so, but you know, as a whole, makes the situation, you know, a very difficult thing to have to do. When you're out, you know, walking your dog in the countryside, you're giving it a lovely time, but by abiding to the law and actually keeping it on the lead, you're not only protecting any potential livestock, but you're also protecting your dog from, you know, a severe situation where it may be shot by a farmer, or where you end up in, you know, a surgery such as this, and you're having to put your dog down as a consequence of not having it on the lead. I mean, it's just so sad, because it really is such an easily avoidable situation by simply just keeping the dog on the lead.
As a farmer, we are more than welcoming people into our lives. You know, this is our office, but please, when you come, will you respect the countryside by putting your dog on the lead?
The countryside's here for everyone to enjoy. It's our workplace, and it's here for you to bring your dog and enjoy. Just keep your dog protected, keep the sheep protected, and the other livestock.
The cold facts are that this is the law, so please, we appeal to the public. If you're walking your dog in the countryside, use a lead and don't risk your dog being destroyed.
If you are up on the mountains, enjoying yourselves and, you know, spending some time in Wales or wherever you are, please keep them dogs on leads, because it'll mean a lot less stress for the sheep, for the farmer, and for all of us.